Now, I'm not one to gossip, but I will bring you the tea. Welcome to Chronicle Speaks.
Please, please, I don't have any time for any gossip now. Eh? Yes.
Look up. Now, your boy Kevin Hart is back in the headlines, and when I tell you sometimes you have your really, really good years, and sometimes you have your really, really bad years, well, this year, Kevin is probably experiencing one of his worst years ever. But you know what? At least he's blessed to still be alive, right? Now, we all remember that horrific accident that happened September 1st of this year when Kevin and his wife's trainer, Rebecca Broxterman, and her fiance, Jared Black, all hopped into Kevin's 1970 Plymouth Barracuda late at night and crashed in what ended up to be a near fatal accident. Now, a lot of people, including myself, were trying to figure out exactly what went wrong. There were so many questions going around. For one, why did Kevin Hart flee the scene? For two, when he left the scene, why did it take an hour and a half before the police were called if he had a bone or whatever he had sticking out of his back? And for three, if this car was a two-seater, how were three people able to comfortably ride in this car? So to bring you all to speed, if you haven't seen my previous videos or haven't been following this story, Kevin and the riders were in the car. Kevin was allegedly in the passenger seat, and then they said Rebecca Broxterman was in the back. Her fiance, Jared Black, was the one driving. This is all allegedly because I wasn't there. This is the story that they told the police. However, they ran off of the road down an embankment. Kevin's security was following them. Kevin's security was able to get Kevin out. However, the two others were left in the car. Kevin was able to leave, but before leaving, an eyewitness said that he looked at Kevin and Kevin looked at him and Kevin said, "Who the f- is that?" Then Kevin left. Kevin went back home, which was about a mile away from the crash site. However, it was an hour and a half before his wife, Aniko, made the call to the police. Now, Aniko sounded like she wasn't all the way there, but she said that Kevin was the one that was not coherent, and it looks like he had some type of bone sticking out of his back. Now, as far as the two other riders, they were trapped still in the car, but an onlooker was able to try to help get them out. Since he was not able to get them out, he did call the police. And you can hear that on the 911 call. Well, over a month has gone by, and now the crash report has been released, and it's given some details as to why the accident happened. Now, they're saying the alleged driver, Jared Black, gunned the engine and lost control. Now, TMZ is reporting that the engine was a 720 horsepower engine, and the sudden acceleration and loss of control is what caused the vehicle to spike and end up crashing into a fence and down an embankment. Now, they are saying that neither of them were wearing a seatbelt and the car did not have any safety harnesses. Now, of course, the safety harness isn't even an issue because none of them were wearing a safety device. Now, there were no mechanical issues with the vehicle. This was pure bad driver error. Now, they're saying that Kevin Hart had three fractures to his spine and Jared Black's injuries were consistent with Kevin Hart's. Now, Rebecca Broxterman was the one that walked away with no injuries. She just went to the hospital, I guess, for a little bump and bruise here and there. Now, although the accident report didn't show where Rebecca was sitting, they're saying that she was found pinned between the top of the passenger seat and the collapsed roof, facing the windshield. But if she was stuck over Kevin's seat, you mean to tell me that Kevin left her dangling there? Like, how the hell did his exit conversation go? Like, you know what? I'ma holler at you, y'all. I gotta go home real quick. I'm hungry. Gotta go check on the kids and the baby and the wifey. Like, what did you say? Because I'm gonna tell you. If my arms was free, there's no way in the world Kevin Hart would have got out of that car. If I'm dangling there and you gonna leave me there, chokehold, it's over. Like, bruh, you didn't even call for help when you did get home. I don't know about y'all, but I swear I think it's more missing to this story. Now, who knows if we will ever find out the truth, but Kevin did release a statement through his attorney, and he says, "I have nothing but love for Jared and wish him and Rebecca a speedy recovery." Oh, y'all call me an instigator sometimes, but for him to say, "I have nothing but love for Jared," and not, "I have nothing but love for Jared and Rebecca," I guarantee you Rebecca was in the back seat, was like, "Baby, gun it, gun it." You know, the bros gotta stick together. I don't know, but I sensed a little bit of hostility in his comment.
Overnight, in a brief statement, Hart telling NBC News through his attorney, "I have nothing but love for Jared and wish him and Rebecca a speedy recovery." Hart's attorney also revealing his client is still not all the way back to work, despite clocking in this week for a few hours to help promote his new Jumanji movie. The lawyer adding Hart's return to full-time action likely won't happen until the new year, assuming everything stays on track with his physical therapy. A world-renowned funny man on the road to recovery after a devastating accident that could have taken a deadly turn.
Hey, Steve, what if anything do we know about how his recovery is coming along?
You know, Craig, only his inner circle would really know that for sure. But we know he's taking his recovery seriously and slowly. His representative says Hart hasn't been walking much in those Jumanji promos. And right now he's sitting most of the day, although he can walk on his own. And his wife says he'll be just fine.
Right. Now, they're saying that the three people that were in the car, Kevin Hart, Rebecca Broxterman, and Jared Black, are all going through with their quote-unquote big lawsuits. I don't know who they're going to sue. They're already saying it's not the car company who is at fault. This is a driver error, so I don't know who's going to sue who. However, they're going through with the lawsuit. Now, since we're just leisurely talking about lawsuits and Kevin Hart, let's talk about this. So about a week ago, felony extortion charges against his friend JT Jackson were recently dropped, although he still faces other felony crimes. Now, just to refresh your memory, back in 2017, when Kevin Hart's wife, Eniko, was pregnant with their son, Kevin cheated on her while in Vegas with a chick named Montia Sebag, where the late night, early morning rendezvous was videotaped, and his friend JT Jackson attempted to extort Kevin for $5 million, stating that the money was needed or else the tape would be released. Well, the tape was released anyway and no money was given. Kevin issued an apology to his wife and his family, and he was shocked that JT had anything to even do with this. In a tweet during the time of this happening, Kevin said that his mind was blown and he was at a loss of words and simply in disbelief. Now, the LA District Attorney's Office filed a motion to dismiss the first count of extortion by threatening letter. Prosecutors did not have enough evidence to convict Jackson with the criminal charge. The threat was, give me $5 million or I'm releasing the video. And this was posted to public comments on an Instagram post where the comedian apologized to his family and friends for his infidelities. Now, since it was a comment, it did not count as a direct message to Kevin. Now, although JT's attorney said his client did not extort Kevin, prosecutors are still going after Jackson for other crimes, including two counts of unauthorized use of personal identifying information, as well as attempted concealing and selling stolen property. Now, if you recall, Montia, the girl in the tape, is suing Kevin Hart because she thinks he tried to videotape their encounter to use him getting caught as a part as a skit in his next comedy tour. But sis isn't suing the friend that everyone already knows is involved, because sis knows he doesn't have any money. Montia Sebag filed a lawsuit for $60 million in federal court in Los Angeles, but according to court documents, the suit was thrown out by the judge over technical legal issues. Either way, your boy Kevin Hart has had quite a year, and I would love to see how this new lawsuit regarding the car accident is going to pan out for not only him, but for the other two passengers as well. I don't see Rebecca having a claim because she knowingly sat where there were no seats or seat belts. I don't see Jared having a claim because he didn't have on his seat belt either. And according to the report, the accident is clearly his fault. And as for Kevin, he didn't have a seatbelt on either, and you let someone drive your muscle car knowing he didn't have the proper knowledge to know the speed behind the car with a demon engine. I say throw the whole lawsuit away, and my friendship with Kevin would be thrown away as well, because I'd be darned if you leave me hanging upside down in this car while you dip off and you don't even go and get me help. Child, it would be over. Anyway, what I need you guys to do is leave a comment. Tell me what you think about all of this Kevin Hart madness. The three of them still going along with these lawsuits, these big lawsuits, let them tell it, knowing that it's really nobody to sue because everybody is at fault in their own way. This was a single car accident and everyone in the car had some type of fault. Y'all seem to love my Kevin Hart story, so I can't wait to see what you gotta say in these comments down below, because y'all already know how we do. We're gonna heat them up. So go ahead and leave your comments, and you know how we do. We'll talk about it down below. Talk to you guys later. Bye. Now, before I end this video, I want to tell you about a company called Ash Kicking. Now, you know your girl Chronicles would not promote a company without doing one of those thorough Chronicle Speaks investigations, honey. And Ash Kicking definitely passed the test. Y'all make sure to check out ashkicking.com for one of the best 100% natural home fragrance and beauty products, honey. And use my code Chronicles at checkout for an extra 15% off just for you. And before you go, don't forget to hit the bell for notifications, like this video, and subscribe. And we'll talk to you guys later. Bye.